Welcome aboard to Ladeus Gaming and the last game in the REL this season. I'm going to take a look here real quick. I got a little bit of money to go up against Spoony Bard here. No. What's he got? Mighty Blow, Block, Dirty Player, Jump Up, and Strip Ball? Actually, I'm going to try this guy. So bam, there's that. And for my last bit of change, let's go ahead and get that Bloodwiser Babe validated. So Spoony Bard is currently in second place in our league. There was a little bit of hype about these two Dark Elf teams going up against each other because we've been running neck and neck and very close to each other for the whole season. But to be honest with you, right now I'm in third because my last game was a tie. So I have to beat him to stay tied with him, I think. But either way, neither one of us are going to the playoffs. And I think, I'm not sure, both of us will get promoted to Division 2. We will not be joining us, and we are playing in the fresh market. That's not something that happens too often. Star player. Spoony had a couple of spin games in the beginning of the season. So he has a strength up blitzer, I think. And he's got a pretty vicious witch elf. She has Mighty Blow, I believe. So we'll see what happens. Not sure how chatty he's going to be, but I'll see if I can keep you company during this. And should he type anything, I will read that to you. I told him greetings and welcome to the market. We'll see what happens. Sit here and look at the goblin. Yay, the goblin. Alright. He's chosen to receive, so we will do a little bit of shuffling here. Them off. I'll put honest with you, at this moment I'm not sure where I want my people to be, but I'm working at it. Got three blitzers on the line, but I don't want the one with strip ball up there, so I'm gonna move him back here. I'm gonna go ahead and put him there. We'll go to this style, try to try to minimize the amount of blocks he can throw on me. We'll go with this. Let's take a look at that. Here she is with Mighty Blow and Block. And her friend with Wrestle. The movement up blitzer, sidestep, lodge. A guarding blocking lineman. What else do we have? Sidestep blitzer. There he is. There's Yang. Yang is a blitzer with strength and tackle. Both he and I have one piece of tackle. See how that works out. This is the star player I picked up with Jump Up, Dirty Player, Block, Mighty Blow, and Strip Ball. So I'm hoping he causes some trouble. a blitz in the early game would be quite nice. I've not got to see too many of Spoon Bar's games, so I don't know if he's much of a passer. I kind of assume he isn't. Most people aren't. I do have my kicker here. I'm not sure what good he's going to do, but we'll see. I don't think Spoony Bard has a kicker. I don't think he does, but he does have this one extra fresh lineman over here. Probably won't see him for a while. With the extra elves over here, I may throw a little bit more I may try to throw a few more fouls than people are used to seeing. I don't know. I'm a very wait and see what is required. Okay, in this case, I'm just going to put it over here in the back. Go ahead and get into threat range right off the bat. Oh, my star player has strength 4. I did not realize that. That does put me on a little bit of even kilter with Spoony, and let's see if we can't put this guy off the game right off the bat. Can't get him off the game, but we did get him off the pitch. What is that? Okay. Go ahead and put him over here in danger. Put him up in danger. You here. Just gonna try to focus and attack on this one side. Now this is not a great idea. So I'm gonna go ahead and be stupid. It worked out. I'll be stupid again. It worked out. So not to leave him there, because we didn't want the Witch Elf to be able to just surf it. So this is going to cause Spoony One here to. He's either gonna have to pull back or he's going to have to push forward with a pass. Now, he does have a lot of free players that I can't do anything about. So here comes the stab. Which is a failure for now, which is part of the reason why I took my assassins off the field. They're just not going to be able to do what I want them to do against Armor 8. They can barely do it against Armor 7 at times. I don't know how much he's going to commit to getting the ball. These three here are going to either make this play or break this play for me. If they screw up or don't go anywhere, it makes it for me. If they get out and he's able to get it to them, then it's going to break me. It looks like he's going to try to protect the ball, which works out actually in my favor. I want him to be a bit conservative. I'm not worrying about winning a bashing war with him. That star player has halfway paid for himself right off the bat. If I can get him to do that a second time with someone important, I'll be pretty happy. Alright, so he's got some dodge there. The only player I have is over here, I think. I'm wrong. I do have a tackle player, don't I? Maybe I don't. Maybe I'm taking the wrong team. I play a handful of teams, so sometimes I forget what I got. I do not have tackle. Alright. I do, however, have strip ball, so if he picks up the ball, I have a shot at knocking it out of his hands. Let's see what he does. He's gonna try to surf. He'll have to re-roll if he wants to push it, and he did. And he does. It doesn't hurt me, but it does make me lose an elf off the bat. Got a lot of dodging at the moment, I think. Yep. He has used a reroll, so the next thing that does fail for him will give us a turnover. There is that to look forward to. Looks like he's abandoning this front line. He has also, of course, abandoned his assassin there. He may give that a shot. Give us three dice against him. Face that guy for the giggles of it. Works. So he's stunned. Not the blow I'm looking for, but it will do. And we'll go ahead and base this guy. Try to stall out his little passing that might happen. And there we go. We do get that maneuver. Cecil is dead. That will most likely be an apothecary. And straight to substitutes. That was different. Not a single. Spoonie stated, what a start, and I just let him know it has been indeed. I did sneak away with that that foul over here. It was not an important attack, but it was open, and I wanted to give it a shot. seeing a cage. Maybe. I'll let you know when I know. Looks like he's going to try to move the ball forward. Not sure the men. I'm not sure the reason behind that. Maybe he thought the same thing and changed his mind. Kind of down. He's going to go out there and just the ball out there in a position where it can be stolen, or see him getting over here into this kind of a fake cage. Hey, you had to go for it. That was different. One die block in which he wins. But at least he didn't push him, so that helps. And the passing threat is existing again. So I'm going to aggressively base elves. There's one. Go ahead and stand him up. And 5. Let me see something here for a second. That's 50. I don't like that, so I'm not going to do that. Three dice against this guy, so I'm gonna get it. Let's see if we can't ruin this blocking ability of his. We cannot, so. What we can do is just go ahead and base here. Dodge did its same thing, so we won't push our we will push our luck a little bit. We'll base the witch elf. So that's. Had Dodge not done its thing, had I still had it available, I might have tried maneuvering a little bit, but the assassin's the only one who can, and this witch elf. Well, and I guess this blitzer here. So that's three pieces that aren't based, so they can just pop up and do what they need to do. So he's going for the 2-on-1 there. With her here, he can get 2 dice. But if the frenzy doesn't work out in his favor, it may trap him, I'm not sure. There's a lot of math going on here that I'm not worried about. I don't need to push his elves down, I just need to get that ball out. And I need to keep an eye out for that tackle. The tackle is off the field. that makes my life a little easier. I can dodge with only the normal problems of double ones and whatnot. A good solid blow for him. Sure what his plan is. So just keep running back and forth across the field. We'll dodge that one. I know it puts me in a tight spot, but it also makes him have to commit. If he wants to put me in a tight spot. Which he has. The ball carrier has a sidestep, so he's going to be pain in the neck to knock down anyways. All the dodges are now Spoony Bard's. And re-roll. I love it. I'm not sure what he's looking for. Maybe he's trying to put that guy in a position to score with a pass. I really don't want to have to depend on our intercept. But I may be stupid here and try something dangerous. First thing I'm going to do, however, move all my L's into a position that causes great discomfort. Sure what to do with this guy, so what I'm going to do is nothing. If you don't know what to do with him, that's the crazy play for this turn. Oh, he was trying to use shadow. He's deciding whether he wanted to use shadow or not. We're gonna push. He can drop the ball. And now we're gonna do this. It worked. Continues to work. We're gonna throw it. The hell with it. If he makes it, he makes it. If he don't, he don't. Oh, well. Always the bridesmaid, never the bride. There's a successful stab. The stun. This guy's going down. It's just a matter of whether he wants to push him or drop him where he is. Now this guy is in serious danger of being surfed. Bard's winning the one die war. So here comes the surf. I survive it. I'm down another elf. Trying to go for that pass. Not sure what's happening here. A lot of indecision, but it's all right. Maybe I'm just hyper. Goes. Two going for it. Maybe there's a pass, maybe there isn't, I don't know. So there's a reroll. And it drops in probably about the best position you could have possibly asked for. See if we can't bump this guy away. He's gonna sidestep where he wants to go. We'll see what happens. We'll follow. Swarm this mess. I don't think I'm gonna get in there, so we might as well see what else trouble we can cause. There's a pow. If this works, he's got to jump up. And she's got dodge, so it did not do what I needed it to do. But it causes some. This where there's some English in it. It causes some havoc. Alright, so that's where we stand. Just in a clustered mess of elves. Do its work, which means pretty good for me. It's just gotta bump this guy off out of the way, and then he doesn't have any tackle zones on the ball. However, if he does knock this guy down, he's gonna fall here and it's gonna scatter ball. So this blitz will knock him over here. Committing to the brawling. The one dive pal doing its work. A little bit of there was required, but it seemed like a pretty straightforward thing to do. Now the only question is he going to stall? Which if he does, I'm assuming he's going to come over here. Which he is doing. So if that's what he wants to do, we'll just do the whole beat everybody up and blah blah blah. Elves to the chase, as it were. And that is that. So let's see if he continues with the stall or if he's going to go ahead and score. Thank you. Well, folks, I'm not sure what's going on. I wish I had something more interesting to tell you other than here's another 4 minutes. I don't know. The last person who kind of played like this was Steve, and he ended up winning, so maybe it works. I find it boring. So this reminds me of a time when I was in the third grade and it took forever. The end. Best story ever. Maybe he's going to try to walk me out to the side. I don't know. Gives me a few rounds to tie it up. One of those made it back up. I think that was Yang. See what happens next. Most likely I'm going to remove the kicker from my side of the field. Charging in and stabbing of these witch elves. In armor 7, it may be worthwhile. Figure out where he's going to be. Alright. So first thing we need to do is remove you. Or the blunt dodger. Second thing we need to do is see what skills are here in the middle. Guard. Lovely. Well, if guard's gonna be in the middle, let's put him in the middle. And we'll put U11 in and U12. Here, this one here. We'll put the Kiwi kid back here in the back to be our disappointment, like usual. However, we'll keep Lime Juice here as our midfielder ball handler. And let's see if we can't cause some people to go to the hospital. Quick snap. Let's use it. And stick around against them guys. Everyone got the free movement, might as well use it. go. First thing we'll do is move our three stabs here. They're not the stabs I want, but I will take them. They didn't do squat. But that's okay. Didn't really expect them to. And base that guy. Try to get this one. I have no skills. I'm hoping I don't get screwed with the one. I didn't, so I'm going to drop him. He's KO'd. Get him out. That helps out. A lot of help from this part of the cage. Let's go ahead and move our runner up before I mess something up and forget to move him. Let's go ahead and move you, our emergency backup ball handler. He has done quite well now. Let's go ahead and see if we can get a scoring threat out in the world. And can we see another moment? Yes, we can. So our blodging blitzer is getting out there to be our catchers, as usual. Let's see how Spoony Bard reacts to this. See if we can't put him on the back foot. I have two rounds, so I don't need to be totally psychotic and hard pressing, but I also don't want to lollygag and miss my chance. We have committed heavily to this side. There's nothing we can do about that. Pretty good opportunity to steal the ball, but our pass just wasn't in it. Really makes me miss my high elf passer on a different team. Okay, I think Spoony's gonna end up hitting coconut water there. May even try to surf him. Not sure where Yang is at the moment. He's the only one with tackle, so I do worry about him a little bit. Oh, there he is, right up against me. Waiting to see what happens here. I may see if I can just pass it or hand it off to Cherry Crush. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Would be a 2 going for it, but I do it. The handoff would be a 67%, followed by a dodge. One dodge. He's got dodge. It's going to depend on what Cecil here does. If Cecil follows, that's going to cause an extra step with us. I'm going to have to move Cecil if I want to do that plan. But then again, this might cause trouble, so... He'll either re-roll it or wrestle. Looks like he's gonna wrestle. And there's the skull, so he's stuck with that one. Well, no, he had a reroll. He just should have knocked it. So I am going to put him downfield as a possible scoring option. The ability 5, why not? Let's go ahead and get our stab on. No. Alright. Let's see if this works. It does not. What? Can't beat him. Beat him. Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's not gonna do what I wanted it to do. Let's see how he answers this. Necessarily the move I wanted to see, but it also doesn't really hurt me that much. Because I have dodge, I'm not sure if I need it. I think the blitz. Might as well use it. That was not the right maneuver. And oh look, my one die's come up skulls. What else is new, right? Thought I had a 2-die, but I didn't realize this guy could steal one of the attacks. So, that screws me up pretty bad. Guess I ought to go slower then. Out of scoring position, so I'm not worried about him. Which just leaves this guy, which he's about to get hit. And we're wrestling. Means pretty much Cherry Crush is screwed. If he doesn't get knocked down, this might keep me in a scoring position. And tackle does its thing. Great. All right. To be honest with you, I just really want to end turn.
Garcia.
See what happens in this half. Maybe it's time for the dice to work in my favor. Trying real hard not to be salty, but it's kind of hard when things work out for your opponent and not for you. I think I'm gonna be a jackass. Yes, I think I'm gonna be a jackass. Get our hate stab on. Well, it's a stun. It's something. Let's see if the old peewee kid here can pick up the ball, which he does for once. Nice, nice change of pace. Scoring potentials, hopefully. Let's see if our other stab works. Does not. That's all right. Doesn't count on that one. There you go. Good times. Good times, kids. Let's do this here. Move you forward. Let's see what that does. Try to work the assistant, I believe. Ah. going for it. I don't know what help that will do, but we'll see. We will use the dump off skill. My passes are twos. Skulls and ones are gonna love that. So what Spoony may be forgetting here is by freeing up this guy, I do have a shot at using strip ball. Not a great shot, but I will. The other option is I may just come up and stab the guy. I needed, but I guess I'll take it. Yang there had a hard time. Man, you know what? Take it. Hoping for a slightly luckier bounce that one of these guys could have picked it up and passed it, but looks like I'm gonna have to fight the whole half for a tie. Spoony Bard here might actually shut me out for the first time in this season. I've been able to score at least one touchdown every game. In fact, I scored one against my Dwarven opponents in the first half. We both tied the game 1-1. And the only other time I scored one, Yayo kicked me down to one because Steve won that 2-1 and the Orcs were able to put me at 2-1.
Oh!
use all the extra tackle zones I had. Used his blitz yet, so we'll see what happens there. Not sure what's going on. Plotting and planning. He's playing 2-minute turns. Going to be more one dime magic for the spoony one. About elves. Let's see if we can stab on her. Not. I'm gonna try to do the dodge out. Good times. Into the six. Get out of dodge maneuver has worked. Try to see if we can't put him on his arse. Is free. And dodge is free, so. We'll just let that one ride. Failed stab, because that's the theme of the game today. I'm alright with that. suppose. Just remember, we did kill a guy, so if there's ever any injuries, he's going to be stuck with them. Yang's going to do his thing and see how that works out. Well, he had to use the dodge there, so it was that. His wrestling is going to cause a lot of fun. But he won't need it because Pat. Okay, so he's going to push Orange Crush to free Yang up to move. Which is going to cause him to do what now? I'm not sure what that move was all about. He really wants to frenzy attack this assassin. Looks like he's gonna get his shot. Double skulls, that's gonna use his last reroll. And it worked out for him. So, that assassin caused him to use two rerolls. I'm on board for that. See if we can do some simple elven passing. Followed up by maybe a simple elven handoff. We can. No one is more surprised than I am. Most likely go here or here or even here to keep the runner tied up, which is what he did. So I'm not gonna make that. I have to have a pal, and half the dice can screw me, so why bother? I will throw this one though. Actually, I'll just go ahead and I think I'll let that roll. That worked out in our favor. That was a shot in the dark just to get him free. And since he is free, let's do this. We'll make it or we won't. I'm not rerolling. Both assassins were strong. I don't understand Spoonie's mentality here. The sooner I score, the sooner he gets the ball back and can win the game instead of tie it. Well, at least we get a level up at the end of the season. That'll be helpful. I just don't know if I want to play this team again. Maybe if I got some comments telling me one way or the other, we would go with it. Alright. Here's the attack. And the going forward is failed. And he's stunned. Cool beans. Cheap stab. Success. Another stun. And I have to decide, am I going to crappy stalling or what? To be able to hold in to where I'm at on the message board, or not the message board, but the leaderboard. Spoonie there just said his armor, this game, oh god, disarm. So the jelly board, one of my highest scores on the team so far. Yeah, four people knocked out, don't worry, here's three of them back. And I'm the one with the blood loss about. Alright, so we're gonna leave the assassin out, I think. Let's take a look. Yeah, we're gonna leave the assassin out, and we're gonna go very aggressive. He's gonna have the four turns to score, and I have three to steal it. I don't know how much hope I have in that, but let's see. I gotta be honest with you, Spoonie, if you watch this, I'm looking for injuries, dude. You already used your apothecary. I don't think I've killed anyone this game. I might have gotten one. This season. Also, Spoonie, if you watch this, you're a slow player, and it's driving me nuts. It's making me rude, and I don't like being rude. Spoonie, come on, man. Just because they give you 4 minutes doesn't mean you gotta take them all. Alright, now that one was just a joke. Not really, though. Well, maybe a little. Squirrel. At least I got sweet tea. Man. 2, 4, 4, 5. Hopefully that's all his good numbers. He'll start rolling ones. So Edge, the sidestepping, fast-moving blitzer, is the one that's out, which means Yang is still on the board somewhere. I believe he's got another... There he is. He's got another sidestepper fella. Real pain in the doodah. And I have to decide, am I going to try to cram this ball all the way in the back again? Especially near that sidestepping pain in the ass. I don't think I am. I think I'm going to try to hit here. Didn't think I'd get another blitz, but hey. That's okay, because it didn't go where I wanted it to anyways. Our stab held, or our armor held against the stab bar. Hopefully this will cause him to be a little aggressive and maybe roll a 1, because that's what I'm waiting for. He needs to roll a 1 on a character without a free reroll, like the dodging. A lot of L's over here on one side of the field. Going with any of this. Guess we'll all be surprised. Like I said, he is winning, so maybe taking forever is a good strategy. Don't be salty, baby. Don't be salty. He's going to try to frenzy blitz. Not exactly sure why, what he's hoping to accomplish. Elves. Now two. I didn't plan it, but realistically, that guy was the best. Dodge would not have mattered. Actually, we will leave the assassin alone. Not sure. Let's put our former journeyman up next to him. Put our kicker over here with Yang. Yang still has, you know, the advantage with block and all that, but. See what this does. Yeah. stun. I've never done it. Dodge again! You going for that one? Yep, come on in, buddy. I was out of movement anyways. Damn, it's successful. And he's dead. Ugh. To broken jaw. Can't miss next game, there isn't one. Ha ha. That'd be pretty cool. Be pretty, pretty cool. If he does pick that up and drops it, I've got this dodging guy right here. I'm gonna try just to run in, steal it, and get out. Could technically score. Is there any chance for another drop ball? Where are you, Christmas? Why can't I find you? Drop this ball so I can roll dice higher than two. Because if it happens and I score, I get the best ninja cheesy victory ever. That will be all luck, not skill. Yeah. Part of him really wants to do it. So part of him keeps thinking, I'm gonna drop this ball. I gotta do everything else first. I think that's why he decided not to get on the microphone. See? Nothing to worry about. You rolled a 3. Going for it. He's gonna pass. Pass. Catch. You know what, Spoonie? If you are watching this, I'm almost up to the point to just let you fucking have it, so this is over. Oh my god, dude. Okay. Let's see if we get lucky. That ball out. Catch it. There it is. Oh, might as well. I got two rerolls. He said, right about now, I'm wishing I hadn't needed so many rerolls this half. And I reminded him that you could have taken some of these double skulls. You didn't need to reroll them all. I foresee the ability to get the ball, to move into a position to throw it, and getting the interception. Spoony Bard, you're one of the slowest players I've ever played. If we hadn't played that friendly in the beginning of the season, I'd be really mad right now, but I know you're an okay guy. You're just slow. So slow. My ADHD can't handle it. Stop being slow. Yay, he's injured. Yay, he's strength awesome. Look, you got exactly the power. He's not playing scatterball. for the love of Mike. Kid disappoints me once again. Good job, guy. Double flipping ones. Good job, guy. Well, either he's going to go ahead and just continue victory, or he's going to tie me and continue victory. Sad part is I may actually keep that stupid kicker. Strength 2, I mean, I use him mostly just for kicking. I don't really do anything else with him. It's time for Scatterball! Is it gonna land right where he needs it to? Maybe he can pick it up and just walk the fuck in. To be honest with you, I really hate this runner. I think I'm going to fire him. I think I'm going to kill the strength busted kicker and fire this runner. He has been nothing but a disappointment since I picked him up. And there we go. Now there you are, folks. Enjoy it. Leave some comments. How bad is it? So I'm going to give Mighty Blow. And there you are, folks. The end of my run is 8, 2, and 3. I have thrown 23 catches in 13 games, one of which was a bye week. So technically it's 23 catches in 12 games. So I did average just slightly under 2 catches a game. I have 25 touchdowns. If you subtract 2 from that for the bye week, then that's 23 and 12 games. Again, almost 2 a game. I did inflict 1 kill, and I did succeed in 1 interception. My casualties came up from 1 very early in the game up to 19, or season. I have sustained 1 death. And there you are. I hope you enjoyed this ride with me in this season. I obviously did a lot better in the middle than I did at the end. And we'll see what happens in the Rebel League next season. Until then, we'll see you next time.